Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and in this video we're going to look at our descent preparation. Now we're actually not too far from our top of descent, and I would always conduct this earlier than I am, but because I've been creating more videos and speaking a lot during a short flight, I've actually run out of the distance. But I would recommend conducting this between 160 to 100 miles before your top of descent, which is indicated by this downward white tick here on our navigation displays. So the first thing we want to do is get a copy of the latest weather, so we can come down into our ATC comms page, go to ATSU data link here at the bottom, AOC WX for weather at the top there, weather request, and we can enter Echo Golf Papa Hotel for Edinburgh, and we want the meter, which is current, so we'll be landing there shortly. Then we come back and we go to our receive message page, and you should see it pop in here, there we go, at the top. So there's the latest weather, which is 0606 knots, all the nines, so visibility 10 kilometers or more, broken 1300 feet, temperature 10, and the QNH 1009. We cross check out a QNH is in there, correct, ready set. With that, we'd come and check the ECAM page, make sure there's nothing on there which is likely to affect our landing performance, or we need to consider in terms of a system degradation or anything we need to be aware of. That's come up. We haven't got the little STS box which indicates there's something we need to look at, so that's all fine on today's flight. Next, we'll come over and look at our landing performance. So this is found here on the arrival performance page. So we need to make sure we've got the correct runway and airport here at the top. So EGPH Echo Golf Papa Hotel 06 is correct. We're expecting the runway to be dry, and we're going to refresh and apply the latest meter, which is 060, 10 degrees and 1009, as we just looked at. In terms of landing weight, we can look at what we've got now, so 61.8 tons. We've got a fuel burn of 1.1 tonnes on each engine, so 2.2 per hour. We're expecting to be on the ground in half an hour. We are going to use less fuel in the descent, obviously. So we could take, we took one tonne off that, so 60.8 tonnes. We can round that up, call it 61 tonnes for our landing weight. 61 tonnes is in there. We can check top max manual braking, low water brake, water brake medium. I'm going to go low water brake. Idle reverse, so we can see the difference between them there. So we'll go idle reverse today, and flaps config full. With that, I'll come over and arm low water brake over here. And then we come down to our MCDU and get this set up. So we look at flight plan, we look at our radar nav, we look at the progress page, then we look at the performance, then we look at our fuel, and then we look at our secondary flight plan page. So in the flight plan, we want to make sure the correct arrival in there, so we'd go and have a look at that, making sure that's what we expect. So we've got the ILS for 06 on the NP1 Echo, and that's all selected. Then we go through a process of cross-checking all that data. So we'll come into the plan page. We'd range down a little bit so we can see the detail. And we'll also want to bring our charts up over here for the arrival. Just zoom in on those. Pretty straightforward. So we've got INPIP at 260, INREV at flight level 200, speed restriction at ESCDO at 250 knots, and then we need to be 230 knots, flight level 70 at Tartan. So we want to go and verify that. INPIP, flight level 260 checks. INREV, flight level 200. Flight level 200 checks. ESCDO, we've got the speed restriction 250 knots. And Tartan, 70. Although it looks like the speed may be a bit of a challenge there, so we just double check what we've got in there. The speed constraint is in there, but at the moment the the system saying it may struggle to reach that speed because we have quite a steep descent between the Esco and Tartan. We may need to use speed brakes in this segment of the flight. So that's all looking sensible, and we'll also come down and review all the lines, match those up with our charts. We'd also want to look at the go-around procedure, which is straight out onto the track of 058 climbing to 3000, and we'll come into our charts to verify that. Straight ahead to 3000, then as directed. So that's sensible. Next we come into our progress page, and we ensure that we've got GPS primary with high accuracy, and we want to make sure that we've got our landing airport and runway entered here for reference, so bearing 343, 160 miles. Then we come to our performance page. We want to make sure that on the cruise page the cabin rate of descent or the descent phase is at a sensible level, so 350 feet per minute is fine. Then we come over to the descent page and we check our descent speeds here, making sure they're sensible as well. That's actually quite low, but we do have a lot of speed restrictions on our descent today, so I'm going to leave it where it is. But something like 280 knots would be a recommended area to target. Then we come across and we complete our approach information. So we could get our weather on the other box over here. So it's 1009, temperature's 10, wind is 060 at 6, our minimums for the approach today, category Charlie and standard, so yeah, 310 feet minimums. I'm going to go config full, but config free is also very commonly used. Today I'm going to use config full. If you were going config free and flap free, you'd select that, and you'd also come up and select landing flap free up here. Otherwise the system will scream at you on the approach, telling you you're in the wrong flap setting. So config full, and we've got an approach speed VAP of 135 today. Then we check the go around. So engine out, acceleration, altitude 900 feet in there. We want to check our MSAs here. So as we come out, we're going to be climbing in straight ahead. We will enter into a 3000 foot MSA zone. That's really what I want to be targeting there. That's our engine out, acceleration, altitude. With that, I put it back into the cruise page where we currently are, and I'll come down into the fuel page, and we want to do a quick check as to what our extra time is there, because I've got the simulator pause, it hasn't updated yet, so you would check your extra time, the amount of fuel you got in there, so you will know what your options are in the event of a go around or any holding or delays that you may have. And then we come across to the secondary flight plan page, and you may want to put in a different approach, a different runway, for example, in the secondary. So we could plan for 24, which is here. So we've got the other runway set up just in case if things change around. There are many airports where you can expect a different runway, and that may not become clear until quite late on. So it's a good idea to set that up into the secondary. You could also put in shortcuts. So if you weren't expecting to fly the full route, you could perhaps modify that and have that ready to go here. Bring that back to the arc. Range back out. And those are the descent preparation checks in the Airbus A320. I hope you found that useful. If you have any questions on any of that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.